This is it then, race day in Spielberg for this year's Austrian Grand Prix. Not long to go before our drivers hurtle off the line and into the first turn, the Niki Lauda curve. It was renamed in 2019 in memory of one of Formula One's most beloved figures. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 metres above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of around 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn 1 or the tight uphill of turn 3. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Clark, Leclerc, Norris, Perez, Oscar Piastri, Albon, Gasly, Russell, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Hülkenberg, Ricciardo, Sargent, Tsunoda, Stroll, Magnussen, Button, Joe, Ocon, and Carlos Sainz will start from the back of the grid. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Anthony Davidson is alongside me as usual for today's race. We should talk about Williams. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
The formation lab gets underway then, and it's going to be interesting today to see how the dry conditions could affect the lifespan of the tyres. So as all the cars reform the grid, the drivers will be hoping to get a strong start. They'll want to earn some valuable points from today's race, with final communications being done with their race engineers, ensuring the planned strategies are all in place.
Let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy. the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. Okay, good work. Great pass. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 16.2 seconds. you've got a lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Behind is 16.7 seconds. Approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hards next time. window's open, so let's box this lap, box this lap. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Jensen is in the pits. Jensen in the pits. And some information on Leclerc. They've got an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Make use of the overtake button and see what you can do. Green flag. Caution, caution. losing a small amount of time to the car behind. Let's keep pushing. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 21.6 seconds. battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Nice move, good job. gap to your teammate behind is 20.5 seconds. That's P1. That's Hamilton behind. Less than a second separates you. They're on old mediums. Look after these tyres now. You want to finish the race on this compound. All right, 6 laps to go now. That place back. Catching the car ahead, well done, but be aware these tyres need to get us to the end of this race. You're dropping a second a lap to the car behind, 1 second. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. job. Nice overtake. Fantastic drive, that's just fantastic. Amazing, you deserve that race win. Well done, mate.
Well, that might not have been the finest race in history, but there's no question it was a critical win. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Clark.
Let's move on to the constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. Meanwhile, good work from the owner driver's team this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.